Now, News 8's continuing coverage of Harrisburg's budget problems. Tonight, City Council approved a budget for next year, cutting city jobs and raising taxes. It drew a quick response from Mayor Linda Thompson, who says she now has the final say on the budget. News 8's Pete Muntean joins us live with more from Harrisburg. Pete.
Ron, the mayor says she has 10 days to veto City Council's proposed $54.3 million budget, which she calls an attack on her, city employees, and residents.
Ms. Williams.
Yes.
Ms. Wilson.
Yes.
Voting 4-1, Harrisburg City Council passed a 2012 budget Thursday night, eliminating 12 city positions, 10 vacant and 2 that are filled right now. Councilmember Patty Kim voted yes on the budget, despite a 16% real estate tax hike for residents.
But it had to be done. We need new revenue. If we do nothing, we would run out of cash February 1st. So we had to do something before, you know, we be back down to zero.
But there are things that needed to be done. There's still more that we're going to have to do. And so hopefully, you know, the administration will come to the table with us and we can sit down and have one-on-one discussions and go through the process.
This is no more than council being spiteful.
Speaking to the media after City Council's vote, Mayor Thompson said the $55.5 million budget she unveiled last month was enough, adding City Council did not approach her about their new budget.
And it was a coward act they committed tonight by coming at the last hour. And I call it coward because they had ample time to meet with the mayor. Ample time. I've always said I want to work with council. This adversary relationship is not healthy for anyone in this region.
Councilmember Brad Kaplinski voted no on the budget, saying the cuts are not deep enough.
We look forward to making even more changes, more cuts, and revisiting the tax situation come January.
The two jobs that City Council slashed from next year's budget, the mayor's communications director, Robert Philbin, and City Ombudsman Brian Wade. If the mayor vetoes the plan, City Council can override her veto with just 5 votes. Ron.
All right. News 8's Pete Muntean live tonight in Harrisburg. Thank you, Pete.